Hey, what is up everyone? Norman from Future Student University and welcome to our first video in our JSON series. After publishing an extensive series on Retrofit, a lot of developers asked us to do an introduction to JSON. So here we go. So what is JSON? JSON is a powerful library to map automatically from Java objects to JSON and from JSON to Java objects. So with a single line of code, you can do these transformations without worrying about the exact details or changes in the data models. JSON does everything for you. If you want to code along, you can find the code for easy copy and pasting on our website. It's the first link in the description below. A lot of the Retrofit developers are coming from Android, but JSON works either on Android or any Java project. So the example projects we're going to work in is always going to be in Java. But that doesn't mean you can't use it on Android. It works on both platforms the same way. Here we have our Java example project. Nothing fancy, just a simple main class where we're going to work in. I've also already added the Gradle dependency here. So if you want to use JSON in your project, you just simply add this line to your Gradle build and sync the project, and then you have JSON available. Fantastic. So I've already done that, so we can go back to our main class. So what we're going to work with in this first video is the user simple class. The user simple class has four properties. It has two strings, the name and the email. It has an integer value, the age, so in sense of 27, and it has a boolean value, is developer, which is true or false. For everyone who didn't work with JSON before, let's create a quick JSON object which is appropriate for this class. So let's move this over here. And in JSON, objects always are indicated by the curly brackets. So with these two curly brackets, we say, hey, this is an object. Now we have to add the four properties over here. So first, let's start with the name. The property key is always in quotation marks. So the name equals this. And then you add a colon and then the value of that property. So in this case, let's just use my name. Then with a comma, you can separate the next property. So now we would expect email. Again, use a colon to separate the value and add the value. Now next is the age. Again, use the property key in strings, but now we have a number and not a string. Up here we wrapped the value of the property in a string because it is a string, but here we simply state the number. So I'm 27, so I will just state 27. If you want to add 27 as a string, you could do this. Since the 27 is a logical number, we will actually send a number and not a string. Now the final one is the isDeveloper. Now here I am a developer, so this value is true. And as you can see, we're actually stating true again as a value and we're not wrapping it as a string. So this is the string true and this is the boolean value of true. Now you could also make this false if you're not a developer, but I'm actually a developer. So this would be an appropriate JSON representation of one of these objects. So when we work with JSON, we would expect that it creates this same object. So let's do that. So let's jump into the serialize user simple example. Obviously, when we want to transform from a Java object, we need to have that Java object. So let's simply create one. And let's use the same values as I have just used before. So Norman, my email, 27, and true. All right. Well, maybe let's format this a little nicer. All right. Now the most interesting part of this video, how do we create a JSON out of this object? First of all, we need a JSON instance. So we will just do JSON and new JSON. So now we have a JSON instance to work with. And what we can now call on this JSON instance is toJSON. And the parameter for the toJSON is simply the object we just created. Now if we make this to a string, we have this JSON object here. Well, actually it's a string object which contains a JSON. So let's run this. All right, our breakpoint triggered, and as you can see down here, we have a JSON result. So that's good. So let's check what the result is. I'm going to copy the value and add it in here. And as you can see, we have added white spaces and line breaks to make it look a little bit nicer so we humans can read it. JSON actually, by default, makes it as small as possible. So no white spaces, no line breaks. Now, if we format this the same way, we will see it's the exact same result. The values are the same, the property keys are the same, everything is identical. And that was just one line of code. Fantastic. So let's go to our second example. So let's do the other direction when we have a JSON and want to make Java objects out of it. So this process is called deserialization. So let's go into this example and let's close our debugger. Let's make this a little bit smaller. Let's actually close it. And down here I've already prepared the string we have just seen in just a different order. As you can see, the property keys are in single quotation marks instead of the double. It doesn't matter. Technically, the double ones are correct, but then we would have to do tons of escaping, and that doesn't look as nice. So I will use this for now. Let's use a string which has a JSON in it and make a Java object out of it. The process is fairly similar. So again, we take a JSON instance, and on that JSON instance, this time we call fromJSON. And we can pass a string, so we're just going to pass a user JSON string. Here we have to add a second parameter. As you can see, when you look at the JSON objects, they don't have any IDs, they don't have any classes. They're as minimal as possible by just stating the values. So you need to know what kind of objects is incoming. So what we need to do here is we need to say, hey, here's a JSON, but this is this appropriate class for it. So here we would say, this is of the type user simple class. And our JSON can tell, okay, we have this incoming JSON, and we're going to map it to this user simple class and can set the properties correctly. So let's make a user objects out of it, and let's run the same thing. Now what we would expect is that the email, the developer, the name's all the same, but the age is 26 now. So let's look into this object. And as you can see, everything worked. We have the name correctly, we have the email correctly, the age is 26 because this JSON says 26, and we have the user developer, which is true. What you have seen in this short example is how you can use JSON to transform automatically from JSON to Java objects and the other way around. Obviously, there's a lot more to explore. In the next video, we will look at how you can map nested objects with JSON. Thanks for watching. We appreciate you being here. If you've learned something, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more videos in this series. Enjoy coding and make it rock.